For Bob Fosse, life was a cabaret filled with all that jazz and then some. Well, now the choreographer director is center stage with a new limited series.
Yeah, Fosse Verdon dives deep into his relationship with Gwen Verdon and showcases Broadway royalty, including Hal Prince, played by Evan Handler.
You're gonna love Bobby.
I know who he is. He's the one with the hats.
He does a lot more than hats.
He's only choreographed one show.
That is the beauty of it. He's still got something to prove.
Well, we'll meet at rehearsals, I'm sure.
Well, actually, he suggested that it might be nice if the two of you were to get together a little bit sooner. He wants to teach you some of the steps. Watch you move.
He wants to audition me.
He wants to meet you.
In order to audition me.
Gwen, if I didn't think the two of you were a perfect match, I would tell the guy to go take a hike. I promise you.
Evan joins us now. Welcome back, Evan. Good to see
you. Thank
you
very much. You asked if I watch myself.
I know.
You know, I do, but that was the first time I saw that. So I like to watch things three or four times by myself
okay.
in a darkened room.
Right.
And then I'm ready to watch it.
So we should have sent you that ahead of time,
yeah,
just so you could prepare.
Ideally, yeah.
So the second the show starts, though, it brings you right back into Fosse's world with Sweet Charity, with Cabaret.
Right.
Now, did you grow up watching these shows, or did you know much about Fosse?
I mean, I watched cinema, so I did see. I mean, I saw Cabaret when I was too young to really know what Cabaret was.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I was aware of Bob Fosse, but you know, he also produced and directed all that jazz.
Yeah.
When I was 17 years old and already wanted to be in film and theater, so you know, that really crystallized for me a kind of energy and psychology that me and I think a lot of young guys entering the business felt of this kind of you know, somebody who produces this incredibly self-aggrandizing, self-indicting thing about what a horrible person I am, but how it channels my creativity.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of us came to New York and came into the theater and film worlds with a lot of that narcissistic energy and ideology.
Yeah.
So it was a very impactful film for me.
Yes.
You know, and I think we've been talking about this all morning. We're both two episodes in. The show pulls you in from the very start. What we love is that, yes, it looks at the glitz and glamour of this time, but it also gets gritty
yeah.
and into his life and
yeah,
talking
yeah.
about how he was not faithful and all of that. Were you aware of that side of Bob Fosse? And as a cast, which side do you guys have more fun delving into?
I mean, I was aware because of that film, All That Jazz, mm-hmm. and because there's a lot of reading about him, and then Star 80 came out after that. So he was a figure that was iconic to me. I probably knew less about his musical beginnings back then and learned more about that. The show, certainly, and the book that it's based on deal with their relationship and the ways that he was damaged as a child and
yeah.
a young man. You know, he performed in burlesque houses. He was a dancer
was a
and,
kid,
and,
right?
and was essentially molested by, you know, the women that he was working around.
Yeah.
And at least according to his own interpretation of his own psychology, was damaged by that and led to a lot of problems that he had later in his relationships with women. And but I think a lot of people who go into performing in show business are trying, if not to heal old wounds,
yeah.
are certainly trying to get a certain kind of love and attention that for which there's a bottomless appetite. And
what are you saying about yourself?
Yeah.
No, listen, so you're
says
playing,
with a smirk.
You're playing Hal Prince, though, who's
yes.
91,
That's
who just
right.
had a show on Broadway a couple years ago.
And who's a terrific guy.
Yeah, you met with him, right?
And who seems to have no issues whatsoever.
No.
Hal and I spent a great afternoon and evening together. You know, my inroad to Hal, besides the fact that, hey, I'm playing you, can we meet, was there were 20, 25 people that I jotted down when reading his book that were influential in my life that he had worked with deeply and had experience with, yet we had never met.
Yeah.
I was this kid who came to New York at 17, and, well, my first non-paying and paying job were with a guy named Bob Kalfin, who ran the Chelsea Theater Center
mm-hmm.
long ago, that Hal had done Candide with, and that I had done my first plays in New York with, and who gave me my first paycheck. And we went to see a play that Bob, you know, who's close to Hal's age, had directed in New York. And so these guys
like
are both still working.
Of-
And we kind of bonded over the fact that we had this shared history of this tight community and yet had never met.
Yeah.
I confessed to him that the only show of his that I'd ever seen on stage was Merrily We Roll Along,
really?
Which was one of his biggest disappointments. And he said, you bum.
Oh, no.
He said, I bet you've never seen Phantom, have you? And I said, no, I haven't. He said, that's because you're a snob, but that's all right.
Well, what I've seen so far, the show is so good. You are so good in everything I've seen. So you should watch it. You should watch yourself in it.
Tonight is the premiere, and I look forward to it. Massively talented guys, Tommy Kail, who's one of the executive producers and directed the first two.
Yeah.
And Lin-Manuel Miranda, one of the executive producers.
Of course, yeah.
And Steve Levitan, I believe it is,
surrounded by a talent.
An incredible cast.
Yeah. Well, Fosse Verdon premieres tomorrow at 10 p.m. on FX. Evan, thank you so much for stopping by. And I love your shoes, by the way.
Thank you very much.
Couldn't help but notice them.
Get them into the shop.
The shoe cam. We'll bring back the shoe cam.